بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وصلى الله على النبي الأمي برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to benefit in these few minutes we have. Salah is one of the most important tenets of Iman. One of the most important fundamentals of our deen. And in regards to Salah, that would be the first question on the day of Qiyamah. In many chapters of the Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enjoins upon us in regards to salah. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes the mu'mineen in Surah Al-Mu'minun, the 23rd chapter of the Quran al-Kareem, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions the qualities of the believers. And from these qualities, the first quality highlighted after Allah says subhanahu wa ta'ala, after a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, قَدَ أَفْلَحَ الْمُؤْمِنُونَ. Certainly, the believers are successful. The believers are successful. أَفْلَحَ. Now, falah is a very deep, encompassing word. It actually means to acquire one's objective, to be saved from anything harmful, and to remain in goodness. And it's such an inclusive word. It means success in this world and in the next. So successful indeed is the condition of the believer. Then Quran describes who are the believers. And the first quality highlighted here in this chapter of the Quran al-Kareem is الَّذِينَ هُمْ فِي صَلَاتِهِمْ خَاشِعُونَ. Those whom in their salah are khashi'un. They perform their salah with khushu' and khudu'. What is khushu' and khudu'? And what is the meaning of khashi'un? Just to study a few statements of Sahaba radiallahu anhum, Tabi'een and Mufassireen on how they interpret, how do they explain khashi'un. Hazrat Abu Darda radiallahu anhu explains al-khushu' i'zamu al-maqam, to highly respect the condition, the situation one is in salah. Wa ikhlasu al-maqal, and recite the Quran in salah sincerely, only for Allah, with firm conviction. وَالْيَقِينُ التَّامِ وَجَمْعُ الْإِهْتِمَامِ, and give salah utter importance. Following that, وَيَتْبَعُ ذَلِكَ تَرْكُ الْإِلْتِفَاتِ, not turning in any other direction, not right or left, not even turning one's gaze anyway, leave alone the gaze, even one's heart. One should concentrate in putting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's love in the heart, and one should concentrate in pondering over the akhirah and the meanings of the kalam of Allah Azza wa Jal. Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu explains khashi'un to mean those who are humble. Those who are humble in their prayer. They perform salah with humility. Ali radiallahu anhu says khashi'un is that one does not turn his attention to anybody, anyone on the right or the left. This indicates to what we learn from the ulama, that scholars say salah is the mi'raj of a mu'min. This is not a hadith, but it is a lesson. It's an advice that like Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam received this gift of salah in mi'raj, the mu'min, when he is performing salah, he's going on this journey. So when he recites the takbir, Allahu Akbar, it's like he's departing on this journey, and now he is on this journey of the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in communion with Allah. And that's what salah means. Silatun bayn al-abdi wa rabbi. It is the attachment of the banda with his Rabb, with his master, with his mula. Hazrat Abu Dharr Ghifari radiallahu anhu narrates an amazing hadith where Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, La yazalu Allah muqbilan ala al-abd ma kana fi salatihi ma lam yaltafit. Fa'idha altafata a'rada anhu rahu Ahmad wa Abu Dawood wa Darimi. Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, Allah's special attention is on his banda as long as he is performing salah with concentration. Once the servant of Allah turns his heart and mind away, he loses that special mercy of Allah, that special attention of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In Hakim Tirmidhi's kitab, Abu Huraira radiallahu anhu reports a hadith wherein Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam saw a man playing with his dari, with his beard in salah. And Allah's Nabi advised and said, if one's heart is khashi', is humble in salah and alive in salah, his limbs would also be humble and also be obedient and calm in salah. So in salah, we have to concentrate. Think of the meaning of what we are reciting. And if we do not understand the meaning, we should concentrate in the hereafter. What will happen in the grave? what will happen when we leave this world, and also concentrate on the day of Qiyamah, because this is actually a reminder of that. One is standing before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala when one goes into sajda, perform that sajda, the tasbihat there with meaning, with understanding, learn the meanings of that. And also coming out from the sajda, sitting between the two sajdas, our ulama advise, think of how short this lifespan of this world is. Then going into the second sajda, think of the time when we leave this world and are lowered in our graves. And then come up for the second rak'ah. Imagine that time when we will be standing before Allah on the day of resurrection. That's why when Allah Wala explains salah in this beautiful poem, actually explains the condition of our salah in these wordings of poetry, wherein he says,
تُصَلِّي بِلَا قَلْبٍ صَلَاةً بِمِثْلِهَا يصير الفتى مستوجبا للعقوبة تخاطبه إياك نعبد مقبلا على غيره فيها لغير ضرورة ولو رد من ناجاك للغير طرفه تميزت من غيظ عليه وغيرة ألا تستحي من مالك الملك وأن يرى صدودك عنه يا قليل المروءة صلاة أقيمت يعلم الله أنها بفعلك هذا طاعة كالخطيئة.
He says, you perform your salah heartlessly. Such a salah, one actually brings upon himself punishment. You are addressing Allah, إِيَّاكَ نَعْبُدْ. You alone do we worship, and you alone do we ask for help. But your heart and mind is turning elsewhere, unnecessarily, لِغَيْرِ ضَرُورَةِ. Why are you doing that when you are devoting this time for Allah? Concentrate in it. وَلُوْ رَدَّ مَنْ نَاجَاكَ لِلْغَيْرِ طَرْفَهُ. If one who is your junior and seeks time from you, and you now give him your attention, and he now should be addressing you, and he's turning and paying attention elsewhere, your rage and anger would know no bounds. تَمَيَّزْتَ مِنْ غَيْظٍ عَلَيْهِ وَغِيْرَتِي. Don't you have shame for Allah that he sees your defiance and you're turning away? O one who is short of morals, ya qalil al muru'ati, and one who lacks respect, such a salah that Allah alone knows. It is actually, we think we're performing salah, but the way we perform it, it's as though we're perpetrating a crime. And in these words, I feel all of us should actually see how we are performing salah, and we need to improve our salah. Our pious predecessors would actually enjoy their salah. On one occasion, Muhammad ibn al-Hanafiyya rahmatullah alayhi was a great tabi'i, the son of Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu. He says, we went to visit our in-laws with my father, Hazrat Ali radiallahu anhu, and they were from the Ansar. And as we were sitting there, Ali radiallahu anhu said, can I have some wudu, water to perform wudu? So I want to perform salah and find some relaxation in there. So when he saw our expressions, that we were shocked in what he's saying, that generally sometimes people perform salah and then relax. He is saying he wants to find relaxation in salah. So he explained to us. He says, I heard Allah's Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam say, O Bilal, establish the salah. So through that we will find raha and contentment and happiness and peace through salah. Hazrat Mawlana Abul Hasan Ali Nadwi rahmatullah alayhi explains an amazing incident with Hazrat Mawlana Ilyas rahmatullah alayhi. He says that there were few satis, there were three of them. They were climbing this mountain, striving in the path of Allah to meet the brothers in that far away masjid. And whilst they're trying to get there, Allahu Akbar, just to digress, our Amir Sahib was mentioning yesterday what a beautiful advice to the students. He says when he went in Jamaat to Indonesia, he says that one would cry tears of blood when the first Jamaat went there. What was the condition of the deen there, Ya Allah? And then he started crying incessantly. And then he said that when we climbed this high mountain and we got to this masjid on top of the mountain, he says we were amazed to see this kitab there called Fada'ilul A'mal. Fada'ilul A'mal. What a kitab. That means virtues of actions. And I would implore one and all, establish the halaqa of ta'aleem in our homes and use this kitab. Read this kitab. Encourage our children to read and sit as a family. What an environment will be created in the home. An environment of iman, yaqeen, a'mal, akhirah. An environment of peace where the halaqa of ta'aleem is established in the home. The malaika of Allah attend
the gatherings of the halaqa of ta'aleem. So the malaika of Allah will come into that home, and as the malaika come in, the shayateen will flee and run away from that home. Because when we bring light, then darkness will be dispelled. And in this kitab, there's six kitabs in one, but one of the books in this Fada'ilul Amal is the virtues of salah. And towards the end of this chapter, I implore one and all to study the certain section where Mawlana Zakariya Rahmatullah Alayhi brings 12 qualities, wherein he quotes from the scholars, wherein ulama say each of these 12 qualities, each one branches out unto three. And if we learn and inculcate these 12 qualities and bring it into our salah, he says definitely our salah would become one of concentration and devotion. Allah give us tawfiq to do that. Let's study these 12 qualities. Mawlana Abul Hasan Rahmatullah Alayhi says, we were with Mawlana Ilyas Rahmatullah Alayhi and we were climbing this lofty mountain. And as we were climbing, we were tired. Hazrat Mawlana Ilyas Rahmatullah Alayhi said one statement that made us forget our tiredness. He said that how many a mountain Rasulullah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam climbed for the service of his, for Allah's deen and for the da'wah to Allah Subhanahu Wa Ta'ala. He says that one statement made us forget all our tiredness. Finally, when we climbed the mountain and we got to that masjid, we were so tired, we lay down just to gain some rest. And we see Hazrat Mawlana Ilyas Rahmatullah Ali start a lengthy, beautiful prayer, salah, and he performed his nawafil and so forth. Afterwards, we asked him, Hazrat, we tired, you tired, what is this now? He says, Allah's Nabi Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam said to Bilal radiallahu anhu, O Bilal, that through salah I find my raha and my relaxation, and salah is the coolness of my eyes. Allah give us tawfiq. Really, salah is something, is a gift of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we should not take for granted. Sahaba radiallahu anhum were very happy with salah, because through salah our needs will certainly be fulfilled, because Allah's salah is a special way to speak to Allah. Salah is where one is in communion with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Let us perform our salah with concentration and devotion. Yes, we are taking our time for salah. Let's do it properly. Study the hadith. Every salah we perform is actually, we get how much of the percentage of our of the salah we get. So that means we have to take our time properly for salah. And also very importantly, let's return to the masajid. Let's come to the house of Allah. The masajid are crying. We have returned to work. We go to office. Whatever we are doing, yes, we are doing with caution. Why don't we return to the house of Allah? Yes, with caution is fine, because deen allows caution or encourages caution. Beloved brothers, respected listeners, respected mothers, let us return to the deen of Allah, the service of Allah's deen. And we request one and all, especially our men, let's return to the houses of Allah. The houses of Allah crying. Allah give us tawfiq.